Today we are going to study about energy. I will probably just take like half an hour for this lecture. And you know, the main principle behind the energy, yeah, just let me download this, is that it's still connected with mechanics. It's an alternative way to study and solve problems in mechanics, yeah. Because sometimes, you see, in mechanics, we have the second law, F is equal, or the resultant of F is equal to M times A. Sometimes, the force is not constant. Yeah. Sometimes the force is not constant. For example, in a roller coaster, the gravitational force can change because of the slope of the roller coaster's track. And therefore, it is easier to use energy concepts. Yeah. It's easier to use energy concept. So in this meeting, I will tell you about the importance of energy. Okay, if you have question, you can just try to interrupt me. Okay, so energy is everywhere. I think you have studied this since high school and secondary school, that energy can be changed from one form to another form, but it cannot be created or destroyed. So the amount of energy since the very beginning of our universe is constant. Okay. So one important thing is that we don't know the exact amount of energy now, but we know that it is constant quantity. Yeah, because in physics, and the conservation of energy has something to do with the conservation of time. Yeah, so it's very important that energy kept constant. Yeah, energy is the key to future. Yeah, because when we can produce cheap energy, we can produce many important goods and applications with low cost. Yeah, so energy is the key to the future. So how important? It is very important. We cannot live one day, even 1 minute, without energy. The essential life of essential energies to the earth is from our sun, and all the living organism benefit from the energy of the sun. Yeah, without the sun, the temperature will drop very rapidly to 100 Celsius below zero, and many, if not all, life of forms will soon or later die because of the lack of energy. And it's very important for today's world because it can be found everywhere, and it's a hot topic in industry because nowadays there are many alternative energy forms. Yeah, so the most important applications now you feel every day is the transfer of electricity energy into many other energy forms. For example, into light, into heat, into motion. Yeah. For example, if you work on computer, you actually change the electrical energy into many different energies, such as heat to generate, for example, turn on your LCD. On, for example, you can also produce light, yeah, by heating in vacuum the tungsten wire, the wolfram wire, which therefore give you better life facilities, yeah, better, more comfortable environment, and so on. Also, the energy in the future will be mostly dependent on solar energy, and maybe you already heard that maybe in the next years there will be a car that is powered by electrical energy, such as Tesla, yeah, and this in 10 years may produce like 7 million units and replace many of the conventional cars nowadays. Yeah, so energy is a abstract, yeah, it's an abstract concept. It's something that is not easy to define. It's an alternative concept to solve the problems of motions, yeah, and developed from the force and motion concept. Yeah, for example, yeah, you can see here, you have force is equal to mass times acceleration, and when you multiply force with the distance, yeah, you have mass times acceleration times distance, and you have this formula. Yeah, v squared is equal to v zero squared plus 2as. So as is equal to half the change in the kinetic energy, yeah. So half v squared minus v null squared in parentheses. So AS is equal to this. And when you substitute this here, you have M times this value, and this is the change in kinetic energy. Yeah. So the dimension of force times distance is equal to the dimension of energy. In this case, it's potential and kinetic energy. Yeah. So energy can be derived from the force and motion concept. But what important is here, you have to realize, yeah, that to be able to produce some energy or work, yeah, work is later defined as F times dot S. Yeah. In order to this produce some mechanical work, you have to have some displacement. Yeah. So if you pull open a wall, but the wall doesn't move in physics, then you don't do some energy. Yeah. Sorry, you do energy when you create some displacement. Yes. Microscopically, you create some very small displacement in the atomic scale, but in the macro scale, it's not seen. So here in physics, very important to see that there must be a displacement. If you only have zero displacement, even though you feel tired, this is no mechanical work done. Yeah, mechanical work done requires there is a displacement. Okay, yeah, so it's a bridge that connects mechanics with other branches of physics like thermodynamics, yeah, wave electromagnetism, and so on. So the concept of energy is like a connecting the different branches of physics, yeah. Usually in thermodynamics and statistical physics is used very, very abundantly. Yeah. So for example, these are some examples of work. As I said before, as long as there is no displacement, there is no mechanical work. So if the two people here, they don't move, if the two people here, they don't move, then you don't produce any work. Yeah. But when they move vertically or horizontally, you produce some work. Yeah. For example, here you can see a person tractor. Yeah, this, as long as the handle moves up and down, there is some work performed because of displacement and because of the force. Yeah. So for example, here I have to tell you that if, for example, the direction, yeah, the direction of the motion is upwards. Yeah. The direction of the motion is upwards, but the force of the gravity acceleration is downwards. Yeah. And there is another force, which is the force of the pull of this engine, yeah, of this tractor. So because the motion is upwards, yeah, remember the work that is created, the work that is created by the tractor is positive because the displacement S, yeah, because the displacement S and the force is in the same upward direction, which is positive. But when I ask you, what is the work produced by the force of gravity, by the weight? You know, the weight is downward, yeah? But the displacement is upward. So there is F dot S, a difference of cosinus 180 degree, yeah? Because F dot S is equal to Fs cosinus. If they are in a different direction, then there's a different cosinus is 180 degree. So in this regard, we have to be careful about the direction of the force and the direction of the displacement. If they are contrary to each other, then we have negative work. Yeah. But if they are the same direction, they are positive. So the question is, if the work produced by the force of the tractor, then the answer is positive work. The work produced by the gravity is negative. Unless the tractors, the direction of the displacement is from up to down, then they have the same direction and then it's positive. Yeah, so it depends on whether which force. Yeah, if the force is the same direction or opposite direction. Okay. So as I said before, even though you feel tired, if there is no displacement, then there is no work. Also, because dot is defined as the cross product, you see, if the force and the work, yeah, the force and the work is located at 190 degrees, sorry, if they are 90 degrees or perpendicular to each other, Yeah, if they are perpendicular to each other, then this means that there is no work performed because F, S, or FD cosinus 90, you know, from trigonometry, cosinus 90 is always zero. Yeah. So as long as the force and the displacement is 90 degree, there is no work performed. Yeah. For example, a weightlifter, yeah, this person lifts some weight here. Okay. Yeah. But the person doesn't move anyone. Yeah. Just stand here, doesn't move. So there is no displacement. No work is performed. Yeah. And the person is moving horizontally. The force is upwards. So the force and the displacements are perpendicular or 90 degree to each other. In this case, there is also no work produced by the lifting force because the displacement is horizontal, but the work is vertical. So be careful about the direction of this. Yeah. The maximum work is performed if the direction is the same as the direction of the force. In this case, we have to take the projection of the force on the displacement. The projection of the force on the displacement in this case is the cosinus. Yeah. So F cosinus theta is the, for example, if this is 50, this is 30. So 50 times cosinus 30, which is half root 3. Yeah. So what is important, you have to calculate always the projection of the force with regard to the displacement direction. Yeah. There is no work performed in the vertical direction, just in the horizontal direction, in this case. Yeah. The unit of work is called joule, which is Newton meter. Yeah. And then the unit of work in JKS is dyne centimeter, RG. Usually in technical, sometimes engineering, they use dyne. For JKS system, centimeter, gram, seconds. But in physics, often they use it system internationale, which is Newton meter or joule. Yeah. So this is called the mechanical work. It requires a force and it requires a displacement, and the force must have a projection on the displacement. So work can be either positive or negative depending on the components of the force pointing in the same direction as the displacement or in the opposite direction. So work, as I told you before, can be seen as positive or negative. Yeah, this is a nice example which you can read by yourself. A student lifts a box, and the question is the amount of work by the gravity. As a sensor, the gravity is pointed always into the center of the earth, which in this case is downward, and the student box is pointed upwards. So the student box is displaced upwards. So in this case, the amount of work by the gravity is negative. Yeah. The amount of work is negative because the force and displacement is in opposite direction. But the amount of work done by the student is positive because they are directing at the same direction. Yeah. Be careful to change the centimeter into meter first. Yeah. Now you can see here some statements which is not so accurate in this case. Yeah, somebody that is hungry cannot do any work. This is actually not true because you still can do some work, but maybe you don't have enough energy to do some heavy work. Yeah, a construction worker usually eats a lot for compensating work. This is all the daily statements, but in physics, as I told you before, the thing that causes is the force and the displacement. Yeah. So, for example, in this case, work must be defined as the force times the displacement. Yeah, and as I told you before, energy is an abstract concept. Yeah, so in this case, the energy that is required to change from a form to another form, transformed in many forms. Yeah, for example, the gasoline energy can be transformed into, for example, heat, also motion, and so on. Actually, in your car, the conversion of energy is only 20%. The 80% is dissipated into heat. Yeah. So we know here two important types of energy. This is the kinetic and the potential energy. Yeah, kinetic energy is always positive. Yeah, because the velocity is squared. So kinetic energy is always positive. Why is the kinetic energy always equal to half mv squared? This is something related to the fact that force is defined in second law as mass times acceleration. So if you multiply with the distance, as I told you before, 8s will result in half from the formula here. Yeah, so the half comes from insertion of this formula into here. Yeah. So this is where the reason where we have this half. Potential energy is the energy because of the position or configuration of the system. Yeah, for example, when we lift a body into certain height, it has a potential energy because it has some distance from the ground. Yeah, when we release the object, it will fall down and change into kinetic energy. So we have here many forms of energy: electrical, chemical, nuclear, geothermal, and so on. Also solar energy and so on. And this all can be converted into useful energy, usually generating electricity. For example, the water turbine can be used to create motion, and this motion can produce electricity. If you later study Faraday principle, yeah, the kinetic energy will produce some rotation. This rotation can produce a magnet to rotate to, and this magnet can produce electricity. Yeah. It's like a dynamo when you tried to play like Tamiya in the past. And this is the thing that I told you before. Kinetic energy can be defined as the change of the kinetic energy is related directly to the work. Yeah. So the work, yeah, is equal to the change in the kinetic energy. This can be obtained from insertion the formula from Newton's second law, as I give you in the previous slides. Yeah. So what is important is if we want to calculate the work of a certain situation, we just need to calculate the initial and the final velocity. Yeah. So work from the net force is equal to the change in kinetic energy. This is an important theorem called the work energy theorem. Yeah, it's called the work energy theorem. And this can be applied to derivation, as you can see in this slide. As I told you before, it's just putting in the linear accelerated constant motion. Yeah, constant accelerated motion. And you also calculate the potential energy, which is also equal to the gravitational work. It's just the change in the potential energy. Yeah. And this all conservative force. Conservative force means that the force here only depends on the initial and the final position. Doesn't depend on the path or the type of path it takes. Yeah. Friction force is not a conservative force, but in this case, gravity and, for example, spring force, they are conservative forces because the force only depend on the initial and final position. So you can see an example here. Yeah, 2 kilogram book is dropped from 5 meter. If air friction is neglected, then find the change of potential energy. You see, the change in potential energy is just, you can calculate using this, yeah? Mg and the change in the distance is minus 100 joule. Why? Because negative is because the potential energy decrease. Yeah? Decrease means negative. Whereas here, you can calculate the work by the change in kinetic energy. Initially, the kinetic energy is zero, and after that is fully kinetic energy. So actually, kinetic energy of the book can be calculated from the formula half mv squared. Yeah, kinetic energy is always positive. So all the potential energy is not transformed into the kinetic energy. you can try to study this slide again. Okay. So as I told you before, the conservative force is not depending on the path, but only on the initial and the final position. So an example of non-conservative force is the friction force, yeah, dissipation into heat because of the friction between the object and the floor and so on. I also have conservation of mechanical energy. The conservation of mechanical energy, if there is no dissipative force, if there is no friction force, then all the sum between the kinetic and potential energy is constant, yeah. And this you can use to calculate various cases. I think this you can already study in senior high school. So I don't have to explain too much detail again. Yeah. So for example, here in A, the main energy is potential energy. In B, the main energy is kinetic energy. And here is the sum between kinetic and potential energy. So the important thing you have to mention is to make sure there is no dissipative force, no friction force, or it can be neglected. And the second thing is that it must be constant. Yeah, the sum is constant. This is an example. You can calculate this easily if you know the mass times the gravity is 10 meter per second square and the height is 1. So here it is 600. Yeah, here the total kinetic energy is 64 times 60 half, and here is just for example, you can calculate the potential energy, yeah. And then, for example, here I can give you the half 60 times 64. Yeah, how much is this? 30 times 64. Yeah, 1920. So this is all kinetic energy. Potential energy here is 600. So kinetic energy is 1920 minus 600, and here is our 1920 in the form of potential energy. Yeah, so you can calculate based on the information below. In middle there is combination of potential and kinetic energy, which is 1320, meaning kinetic energy is larger than potential energy here by a factor of 2. Yeah. Okay. So this you can calculate like I did. Yeah. And you can also calculate the mechanical energy at position T. What is the height you can calculate from this? Because all the energy here is converted into height. Yeah. So now, what is the definition of power? Yeah. Power is the rate of energy transfer from one system to the other system. So, in studying power, it's important because we not only have to measure the energy itself, but how fast the energy moves. Yeah, this is, for example, important if you want to calculate the amount of energy you use for paying the electricity bill, because it's not the same. You use air conditioner for 1 hour to and 5 hours. You have to pay more if you use it for 5 hours. So you have to multiply the energy times the hour. So it's kawai high, yeah? In terms of kilowatt hour. This is the measurement of how you have to pay the bill. The electricity company have a measurement how much you have to pay for each kWh. Okay, like 300 rupiah in Indonesia for 1 kWh. And this means you can calculate, estimate how much energy you will use in your weekly or monthly plan. Yeah, so the more air conditioner you use, the more heavy equipment for electricity you use, like vacuum cleaner, refrigerator and so on, television, then you have to pay more for your. It also depends on the duration, right? So it's the measurement is in power, yeah, which is how the rate, how fast the energy transfer, energy per unit time. Yeah, for example, a truck, a heavy truck and a car, when they lift the same weight in the same height, they may have the same energy, potential energy change, the same work, yeah. But the power is different because the truck can bring the heavy weight faster than the car. For example, the car has to move slowly because of the heavy weight. So this means the truck has a lot more power than the car, but they have the same, they do produce the same work. Yeah. For example, a car produces force, the average velocity is this. Find the power of the car. See, work is equal to F times S. Yeah. And you know F is equal to M A S. Now, power work per unit time. So M A, you know, S per unit time. This has the dimension of velocity. Yeah. So it's equal to M A V. So M A is equal to F times V. And we arrive in this formula. The key is, yeah, to put the work per unit time here. So we have distance per unit time here. Yeah. Do the same thing for a truck that produces. You can see here that the power produced by the truck is much more larger because of the greater force. Yeah. You can compare this. You can compare this. It's not so hard. So the correction between energy and momentum, yeah, you have a property called impulse. Yeah. A large force works very fast. So for example, you have in this case a force like this, yeah, in a very short amount of time. You can write Newton's law actually in this form. F is equal to the change in the momentum divided by the time, where the momentum is called m times v. Yeah, change in the momentum mv per t. Yeah, dp dt, dp dp dt, dv dt. M dv dt is the definition of acceleration. So we have mass times acceleration. So force equals mass times acceleration is equal to dp per dt, right? Yeah. So you can then write f dt is equal to dp or change in momentum. F dt here is a property which we call impulse, is defined as impulse. Yeah. Okay, impulse is important if we want to calculate, for example, what is the change in momentum of sport activities such as baseball, soccer, and so on. Yeah. So dp is the change in momentum. So dp is equal to mv1 minus v2. For example, here, Ronaldo takes free kick in a game. The velocity of the ball changes from 0 to 20 in. So you have the change in momentum here, yeah, and you have the information about the mass. So just calculate mass times the change in the velocity, yeah. And the average force is the change of the momentum, yeah, divided by the time. The time is 0.02 seconds. So put all the parameters here inside. We have 0.8 times 20 divided by 0.02, and this is the answer. You can do it by yourself. So in analyzing collision, you can use the conservation of momentum, which is an important law in physics. So that means that motion is conserved. Yeah, motion is conserved, meaning the initial momentum and the final momentum must be conserved, must be constant. Yeah, and from this you can calculate, for example, cases of collision. We have elastic collision. Elastic collision means after the collision, the energy is stay the same and the object is fully separated. Yeah. to have an elastic collision. Usually it happens during like we call it billiard ball. Yeah, the collision is sometimes elastic, but when the two balls are sticking together, then this is non-elastic collision. Yeah, full elastic collision, then the elastic coefficient is equal to one. Sorry, zero one. Yeah, non-elastic collision is zero. So you can calculate this is as the initial and this is the final velocity. You have to also consider the change in the direction. Yeah, the change in the direction. For example, to the right is positive, velocity to the left is negative because you know velocity is a vector quantity. Yeah. This is example of elastic collision. Before and after, you can simply use this formula. Yeah. But in non-elastic collision, after the collision, the two mass stays together. So after the collision, the non-elastic collision, the mass will stick each other. Yeah. Well, therefore, they will move with the same velocity. And you can calculate this using the conservation of momentum. Yeah. So you need a lot of practice, a lot of trying to find out your own calculation, because then you can have more confidence in what you study. Yeah. So a constant force works on an object. Yeah. If the work becomes twice and the force becomes half, how far the object displaces new compared to the previous case. Yeah. So the work becomes twice. Yeah, you can use this formula here. V is equal to F dot S. Yeah. If the work becomes twice to F, and the sorry, the work becomes twice and the force becomes half. Okay. So the displacement must be 4 times, right? Because 4 times half is equal to 2. Yeah, you can use this formula here simply to solve this problem. Okay, because today the lecture is only like 45 minutes or half an hour, I will decrease my jokes, yeah. But actually, what you learn in energy is just alternative to the Newton law and can help you in many situations because the problem is no more easily to solve. Yeah. And this is the types of problems. Yeah. 10 gram rubber ball, clay were thrown the wall with the same speed after collision, bounce back while the clay base stuck on the wall. Which ball has bigger impulse? So to calculate the bigger impulse, you have to calculate which one has the bigger change in momentum, right? Because F delta T is equal to delta P. Yeah. Higher impulse means higher change in momentum, higher change in mass times velocity. Yeah. Of course, the rubber ball bounces back. And therefore, the rubber ball has a higher impulse. Yeah. It's not the same. Wrong. Wrong. Only D is correct. Yeah. So this is the answer. Yeah. So for example, if you shoot a bear with a original weapon, yeah, without rubber ammunition, the bear will probably die because you hit and the bullets will go inside. But if you have a rubber ammunition, then the bear will hurt more. The bear will hurt more, but he will not die and will catch you. So be careful if you hit a bear with a rubber shotgun. Yeah, he will not die, but he will feel more pain because of the change in impulse. Yeah. Also, this means if you touch an object more a longer time, then you will feel less pain. Yeah. For example, this is the reason why in boxing, for example, people use gloves, because when you hit a person, then the contact will be longer. Yeah. Delta S, delta T will be longer, F will go down, and therefore the pain will be less. This is why in boxing, yeah, conventional boxing, you have to wear gloves, and this is why there is an airbag, yeah, airbag. When there is collision, you have more long contact with the airbag, and it's hurting less. Yeah. Yeah, this is a linear momentum case. Yeah. Bullet of 20 grams, 10 to the power of minus 3 kilogram. Yeah. This is the mass of the pendulum. Pendulum 9080. Yeah. Gram. 10 to the power min 3 kilogram. Yeah. This is inelastic collision. Find the velocity of the bullet right before hitting the pendulum. Yeah. So after the collision, the speed is 2 meters per second. So we have, yeah, initially MV plus zero because the pendulum doesn't move. And after that, we have the mass of both times the velocity. The mass of both is 20 plus 1980. The velocity is 20. Don't forget times 10 to the power minus 3 because we measure in kilograms. So we have here 2 kilograms, yeah. Okay, times 2 is 4. So 4 is equal to times the velocity we want to know. So the velocity we want to know is 4 divided by 20 times 3. So 4,000 divided by 20, which is 200 meter per second. So the velocity of the bullet before it hits the pendulum is 200 meter per second, yeah, which is a fair number. Okay, so you can solve this by the initial momentum is equal to the final momentum, and because it's trapped inside initial, zero means that fully inelastic, the mass will join with the same velocity, so the bullet and the pendulum will move together. Okay, yeah. Okay, this is it. I cannot finish in 30 minutes, but 40 minutes. I hope that even though I speak fast, you can repeat with the video, yeah, and then mark all the important corrections. So I have like 10 minutes for you for question and answers. Any question, please raise your hand. Speak up in the microphone. Okay. So energy, yeah, is alternative to mechanics. Yeah. By the way, Surya, you already can join the class enrollment, yeah? Surya, hello? Okay. So I will tell you about the quiz. I will give you the quiz in the form of a Google Classroom. So please prepare in the following weeks. Press email Google Mail with your name, yeah, with your real name, or at least there is a name that I can identify to your address, yeah. And I will make a Google Classroom and I will make you join the class, and then there is assignment, and then you can fill the quiz. It's only like 15 multiple choice. Okay, it's okay. Yeah.
There.
Yes.
When will the quiz be held?
I think I will give it maybe tomorrow. Yeah. But you can answer the quiz for a certain amount of time. So I give you like 1 week to solve the quiz. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so it's not in hurry. Yeah, it's like 1 week. So today's lecture is a little bit fast, okay? But I think you get the point, yeah? The important point is energy can be used to solve problem more easily and is directly related with Newton's second law, yeah? Okay, any more questions? Don't worry about the quiz, it's not too hard, yeah? But please, please do it yourself. Try to do it yourself. is a multiple choice. You will be given a link to the Google Classroom. Just prepare a Google Mail with your name. If you don't have Google Mail, you can create now or in the following days. Okay. So energy is very important concept because, as I said, it relates later with the mechanical work in thermodynamics, yeah, and so on and so on. Any more questions, students? Okay, please, because we have still time, try to study the slide one more time. Okay. So I will probably just close today's lecture. I hope that you will have enough time to study again. Yeah. Again, the mechanical energy is important to see the displacement. Yeah. And what direction the force and the displacement is. Okay. So thank you for your attention. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good afternoon, everyone. Yeah. I think for you who like the fast lecture is good news because we close now. Okay. Bye-bye. See you next time.
See you, sir. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.